We've all been there. You feel the urge to pee and start to make your way to the bathroom, and as soon as that shiny porcelain bowl is in sight, though, it's like your bladder goes on overdrive and you suddenly feel like you're about to burst. You gotta get unzipped and on that toilet quick, or you're gonna start redecorating the bathroom walls with lemonade. But why in the world do you have to pee more the closer you get to the bathroom? For some people, this can be a very serious issue, known as latch key incontinence. The phenomenon typically occurs when an individual suffering from an overactive bladder returns home from work or running errands. As soon as they press that garage door opener or stick the key in the lock, the bladder seems to release the floodgates. Suddenly, it's like the bursting of China's Bangkok Reservoir Dam. Only instead of killing 171,000 people, the only casualties are your pants and the entryway rug. Other people who don't suffer from incontinence or overactive bladder, however, still often feel the same sudden and desperate urge to pee as soon as they spot the bathroom door. Scientists are actually unsure as to the cause of this phenomenon, though they believe that it might be due to psychological conditioning. In the 1890s, Russian psychologist Ivan Pavlov was researching salivation in dogs in response to being fed. His initial hypothesis was the dogs would begin to salivate as soon as the food was placed in front of them. However, he quickly noticed that the dogs instead began to salivate when they heard the footsteps of the assistant responsible for bringing their food. Pavlov used this realization to attempt to condition the dogs to salivate, a completely uncontrolled response on their behalf, without any food being present. First, Pavlov exposed the dogs to a metronome, which elicited no response except for a few confused looks, as expected. However, Pavlov then began to expose the dogs to the metronome right before giving the dogs their meal. Soon, the dogs began to salivate upon hearing the metronome even without food being presented. Pavlov had unlocked a very important learning technique known as the conditioned response, and his dogs were lucky to be involved in Pavlov's experiments rather than later Russian experiments where dog heads would be transplanted onto different bodies. You can probably already see the threads of this conclusion coming together. Unless you're from Alabama, you were taught from an early age that the bathroom is the place to do your business. It didn't matter if the bathroom was at home or at the movie theater or your workplace, the bathroom is the one and only acceptable place to do your business. Now your brain is so conditioned to associating the bathroom with making lemonade or dropping kids off at the pool that while the conditioning is not strong enough to force you to have to pee, it is enough to make it unbearable if you already have to pee. Sadly, for most people who use public bathrooms, the association between the actual toilet and you doing your business isn't as powerful as the association with the bathroom itself. That explains why when you use a busy public restroom, the stalls tend to look like someone had a urine super soaker fight in there. And kids, if you're playing urine super soaker, then take it from us. There's no winners, only losers. People with severe incontinence or overactive bladders, however, can find this situation unbearable, and the condition only gets worse with age. That's why doctors may sometimes prescribe medications that can help control the nerves of the bladder, or in extreme cases, may physically enlarge the bladder itself so as to relieve the pressure and need to urinate long enough to actually get to the toilet. For the rest of you, rest assured that while you might have a Superman-like control of your bladder today, as you age, that control erodes slowly but surely, and one day you too will be leaking like a bad faucet upon the side of a bathroom door. While we're on the subject, though, what if you aren't having trouble holding your pee, but rather having issues with getting it out, especially in a public restroom? Known as paruresis or shy bladder, the psychological condition affects a person's ability to urinate around other people. For men, the condition is especially troublesome, as men's restrooms typically have rows of urinals placed closely together, only making it more difficult to pee. The only option for most sufferers is either to hold it or lock oneself in a stall, something that's far easier for women to do than men in busy public restrooms. The underlying causes of shy bladder are purely psychological in nature, and the condition is considered a form of social anxiety. While the origin can have different causes, the main causes are criticism during potty training, being bullied as a child in a restroom, or sexual abuse. To make matters worse, the condition is self-reinforcing, only becoming stronger each time you try to urinate and can't. As your anxiety grows, your body floods the nervous system with adrenaline. This is typically a good thing, as adrenaline can make you stronger and faster in a fight to the death with a saber-toothed tiger like our ancestors might have found themselves in. Unfortunately, all this adrenaline also freezes up the muscles that allow you to pee, which has the convenient side effect of keeping you from peeing all over yourself in the middle of a fight. Then again, we wouldn't want to fight a urine-wielding warrior, so maybe evolution should take a second look at the urine defense. People with shy bladders can have three main triggers. The first and most common is a lack of privacy. If a shy peer can't find some privacy, they might find their bladder freezing up, even if just moments ago they were ready to flow like the Yellow River in China. The fact that men's bathroom stalls don't always have doors or walls, if you live in some countries that haven't mastered not pooping in holes technology, it's thought of being a big reason why shy bladder is more common in men than women. Who is in the bathroom with you can also be a trigger. You might be just fine peeing in the restroom at a Colorado Rockies game, though that's probably because the bathroom and the stadium will be empty because the Rockies are a terrible team. However, if you actually go watch a good baseball team play and use their bathroom facilities, you might find yourself freezing up when you notice a stranger in the bathroom that reminds you of that stepdad that never hugged you and was always overly critical of everything you did. For individuals with this trigger, it's typically certain individuals or types of individuals who can trigger their shy bladder. Emotions are also a major trigger, especially in public restrooms. The feeling of needing to hurry up because of the pressing throng of people waiting their turn at a public restroom can cause you to embarrassingly freeze up. Even just bringing your own emotional baggage into the bathroom with you can make it difficult to pee, though, with anxiety, anger, or fear all working to psychologically block you from weeing. Luckily, there's treatments available in the form of cognitive behavioral therapy. If affected by shy bladder, you can gradually overcome it by slowly being exposed to your specific trigger. Over time, your brain's anxiety response will get put in check, and before you know it, you'll be whizzing with the best of them in the most crowded of restrooms. However, you can physically hack your body into urinating even when you don't want to, or at least help it. The first technique is to take a moment to relax as you're at the urinal or on the toilet, for the ladies with shy bladders. Then, reach behind you with one hand and lightly tickle the top of your buttocks, right around where the two cheeks split. For most people, the tickling sensation can relax the bladder and facilitate the flow of pee. For the men, the second technique involves lightly tickling the tip of the penis by rubbing it slightly in a circular motion against the tip of the palm. Presto, you should be flowing as free as a river in no time. Why these techniques work is because the muscles that control urination are intricately connected to your nervous system and thus easily hijacked. All it takes is some light pressure or a tickle and your bladder will open up in no time. We just recommend you do this inside the privacy of a bathroom stall so you don't get extremely weird looks. Now, go check out What Does Heroin Do to Your Body? Or click this other video instead.